So engineering controls and work practice controls are your first two lines of protection against bloodborne pathogens. Personal protective equipment, known as PPE, is the final line of defense. PPE involves using specialized clothing or equipment for protection against pathogens in blood and other potentially infectious materials. According to the Bloodborne Pathogen Standard, employers must evaluate each task, the type of exposure expected, and based on the determination, select the appropriate PPE. PPE must be provided in appropriate sizes, be readily accessible, and provided to employees at no cost. PPE protects your skin, eyes, and regular work clothing from exposure. Your hands, face, and eyes are the main focus of skin protection. Appropriate PPE could include eye protection, face shields, and the proper gloves for the task at hand. Using gloves has a special emphasis in the standard. Wear them if you can reasonably anticipate that you may have hand contact with blood or other potentially infectious materials. This is especially important if you have non-intact skin. You must also protect your eyes and mucous membranes if there is a hazard of splashing. The rest of PPE is made up of protective body clothing. Scrubs, gowns, aprons, and shoe covers provide a protective layer over your workwear. Your workwear may consist of items that could, in some cases, be considered PPE. For example, if you normally wear scrubs to work, they are considered work clothing, not PPE. If you expect an exposure that might soak through your work clothing, you still need to protect yourself with a layer of PPE. If blood or other potentially infectious materials penetrates your protective clothing, you must remove the PPE as soon as the situation allows. It's the same with your eye and face protective gear. Should they become contaminated or damaged, they must be removed and replaced the moment it becomes possible to do so. When removing your PPE, always assume it is contaminated on the outside. Special caution needs to be taken when removing soiled PPE. Your workplace exposure control plan should include procedures for safely removing PPE. We've included a handout on how to safely remove contaminated PPE on the resource page of this program. Your PPE also needs care in handling, maintenance, and storage. The standard requires that PPE be cleaned, laundered, disposed of, and repaired and replaced by the employer at no cost to the employee. Used PPE must be placed in a designated area or container for washing, decontamination, or disposal. And finally, under no circumstances are employees allowed to take home contaminated PPE. We'll go into the details of PPE usage and care in the next section. We'll talk about the rule requirements, show you more examples, and close with maintenance and repair of PPE. If you're in the healthcare industry, chances are your facility has more guidelines than outlined in this course, and those should be a part of your exposure control plan.